All right, well, thank you guys for joining. We are going to take a look at PlayFab, one of Microsoft's tools. You may have already seen some of the segments we've done before where we've used PlayFab to handle the authentication of our games, to handle the storage and saving of our games, to handle playing on different devices, and it can be used for many more things, including analytics, in-game purchases. We are just getting started with this. Today, we're going to be doing a new application of some of the things we've kind of already looked at. We have done authentication before, we have done leaderboards before, we have done saving before, and we're going to combine them in a way. They are going to kind of come together, and the sort of idea behind it is to use them in a Twitch game. You may have come across streams that have kind of like games running in the background. We are very lucky that we recently were part of the Twitch dev keynote and we got early access to try out their new API where we can integrate Twitch with Unity projects. So one thing I thought that would be really cool to integrate PlayFab with Twitch's new Unity API would be to show people who are in chat that you can kind of see the other chatters and imagine that you're there together in a digital space. We started experimenting with that a little bit, but one thing that we thought would be fun would be to be able to customize your own representations. Then we can even do things like opting in through chat to play a game. We could have a poll to choose who takes part in the game, but the first step is to have these customizable avatars that we can integrate with Twitch to play games with. We are going to be using some things we've seen before, like the authentication, leaderboards, saving through PlayFab. We're going to go through, it's already built. I'll give a demo and then I'll walk through how it's set up. So over here you can see we have our login screen. Let's start it up. And this is just a very rough login. I'm going to log in with a very, very secret password. Close your eyes, don't look. It's very secret. Once we log in, we now have our character that we can customize. So as you can see, we're just testing out some random hair colors. This will be saved automatically. And then if we ever come back, our character will be the way we want it to be. And when we go into the game, we see the other players and the colors that they have picked. In fact, I actually have my own character here. EEE is the username. So it's a very simple version of what it could be. You could even, for example, put in the different random dialogue you want your character to show. So that's the very basic demo, and then I'm going to walk you through how we put it together. First, let's look at our hierarchy here. We have our controls. This has our different scripts on it. So those are all here with their different attributes within them that we've linked up to the assets that need to be linked up to it. We have our main camera here for our login and our character selection. We have our UI, which has the auth screen here that you're seeing. We've linked that up to some controls. In fact, let's look at the login screen right now. Here's our script for the login. So here's our authentication parts. We have the different text elements. So we have to be using Unity UI. We're using PlayFab, playfab.clientmodels. Then on these buttons, we've linked them up to logincontrols.register, which are in this script as well. We are using register PlayFab user request. We need to have a failed option here, which you can use the codes from PlayFab to give a humanized explanation of what went wrong when they tried to register. But for now, we just give ourselves a debug to show the error. So we're just going to use the signup name and set that to the display name so that we can have that to work with later. Then we go ahead and start the game. Similarly, when we log in with an existing account, we use login with email address request. You could use different ways to log in. We've looked at even logging in through Twitch. That's something we're probably going to want to do later. So we can connect the users in the game with the users in chat. But for now, we're just doing the representation visually of the users from PlayFab. On starting the game, we get the score if there's none. So we're actually going to get a hair color number if it doesn't exist yet. And to give you an idea of what that looks like when you set up player statistics, let's go over here. So for this, we go get player statistics request. If we get it and it's successful, and if the results are non-existent, we have add stat here down here where we add the hair color. Using update player statistics, we add hair color, we set the value, and this is what we used to set the hair color. I wanted to show you if we create the statistic, how it looks in PlayFab. So if you go over, you log in and you click on players, and then we're going to go over to statistics here, and you can see hair color has already been added and the value's at 0. So this is kind of what we're getting. We're getting this key and this value, and that's what we're working with here. So once we're logged in, we set that. If we don't have it, we create one. If it exists, then we bring that value into the game. We basically turn off some of these fields so that we can show the character selection screen. And here's where we get the hair color by using get player statistics. Then we can update it and show it in the scene. So as long as the hair isn't null, which is a game object, we can set it to the material from the list using the number of the material on that list. So the hair game object is not null. We have actually some materials on this game object. I brought one in. It's a free asset from the Unity store that you're seeing. And here, I'll show you just in case you're not familiar. So here's the prefab we're using. This hair color has three different textures on it. So we want to make sure that we are changing the one that is the actual hair. And then we save it. So now we save it in stats controls under set care. And we say update player statistics request. And we statistics update of the hair color with the current value that we've just updated to. So whenever we change it, it updates, it saves. We don't need to save it again. So that's how we would set those things. We have one example, but that can be used in a lot of different ways. Next, when we click start game, that opens up menus here that we turn on when we start the game. This is our things that have been linked up to set different values to these and update in the things we just looked at. But if we click next here on our character customizer, we go into the regular gameplay, turn off some of the things we weren't using. We turn on this game object, which includes our first person controller. We turn off the camera that we had before, turn off some of those menus we had up, bring in the characters of the other players, and then we get them to start dancing. So I wait a minute until they're done being loaded, and then we set the trigger on that animator here. Under change profile, make dance. We basically just say for each of the children in the parent that we spawn the game objects to, we get the animator just based on how the prefab set up. Then we also get that character to face the bonfire. So that's what we do with the dancing. But the other thing we need to look at now is the load characters, and that's in stats controls. So here in stats controls, we have get leaderboard requests. So maybe limiting the number of players would be a good idea. We've set it to the number of top 10. We could have done it by the most recent to have logged in. We could do it by a number of different ways, but I thought the leaderboard would be a fun way to do it so that we can have some kind of value that people are trying to improve on. So instead of just having a leaderboard, your character actually shows up in the game. And from the results, we get the display name, which we set earlier when we created the account, and the stat value for hair color. And then we use changeProfile.instance.addCharacter. And here we instantiate the prefab that we set up top over here. We also give a random position of the X and Y coordinates where we spawn them. Then we set the materials like we did before for our own character for each of those. And that is pretty much all there is to know about this. That's pretty much covers what we're doing. There's some basic things here, like clear the characters if we want to. We can set the hair color number using this. We can have a forward and backwards on the hair styles or colors if you want to. But it's pretty straightforward, and there's a lot that you can do with this. Hopefully, by watching this, you have been inspired. So thank you again for watching. I hope you learned something today, and we'll see you next time.